St. Christopher's. For those of you that I have not met yet, and that's most of you, I am the Reverend Lecia Diaz Brannon, and I come from a land of far east called Seminary of the Southwest, and it's my pleasure to join you as your priest and preacher this morning. My role at Seminary of the Southwest is Director of Donor Relations. But I'm also a graduate. I was ordained in 2016 at Calvary Episcopal Church in Richmond, Texas. I made the trek to Texas from Central California, and I got here, and I'm still here. So, let us this morning proclaim the greatness of the Lord our God and worship him upon his holy hill. For the Lord our God is the Holy One. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
There is one body and one spirit,
There is one hope in God's call to us.
One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God and Father of all.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Father in heaven, who at the baptism of Jesus in the River Jordan proclaimed him your beloved Son and anointed him with the Holy Spirit, grant that all who are baptized into his name may keep the covenant they have made and boldly confess him as Lord and Savior, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God in glory everlasting.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm this morning is Psalm 29. We're going to be reading it in unison.
Ascribe to the Lord, you gods. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. God of glory thunders, the Lord is upon the mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is a powerful voice. The voice of the Lord is a voice of splendor. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedar trees. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. He makes Lebanon skip like a calf, and Mount Hermon like an unwild ox. The voice of the Lord slits the flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord makes the oak trees high and strips the forest bare. And in the temple of the Lord, all are crying glory. The Lord sits enthroned above the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as King forevermore. The Lord shall give strength to his people. The Lord shall give his people the blessing of peace.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul passed through the interior region and came to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They replied, "No, we have not even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." Then he said, "Into what then were you baptized?" They answered, "Into John's baptism." Paul said, "John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." On hearing this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. When Paul had laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 of them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. And he proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." In those days, Jesus from Nazareth of Galilee came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my son, the beloved with you. I am pleased." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
The same way as Merry Christmas or Happy New Year, does it?
No.
But yet, it is the season that we are in. How many of you received a calendar this year from somebody you've done business with, or perhaps you bought one for your home? Yeah. It's kind of part of what we do in the beginning of the new calendar year. But while we are 7 days into 2024, we are actually in the third season of the church calendar already. Now, the church calendar is not made up of specific days. It's broken into seasons. And while there are specific days of those seasons, the only fixed day of our church calendar is Christmas, December 25th. The rest of it feels like this circular moving target, depending on when Easter is, and we count back from there. Now, how many of you know what that calendar looks like if I were to send you to Google to take a look? What does it look like? It looks like a circle, right? Because that's how we live in our church calendar and our liturgical year. It just is continuous. Now, it's a spiritual flow more than a calendar. And recently this week, I had some emails about our spiritual flow, and most of them said, get ready for Lent. Lots of things about Lent devotionals. But my friends, we are not even close to that yet. But I think it is our human nature to want to look ahead. What's next on the calendar? What appointments we have coming up? What are the birthdays we need to celebrate? So I don't want to diminish that. But that's not who we are. That's the church. We get to think of time here in the church in this sacred way, this spiritual flow of seasons. Now, I have always enjoyed and grown to love, really, the season of Epiphany. But perhaps it's not for all the right reasons. There seems to be this wonderful relief. We don't have to deal with Christmas anymore. I'm delighted to go into some place and not hear Christmas carols. Because honestly, every year they start earlier. I also find there's fewer distractions now. Less busyness. Perhaps less on our calendars. And we get a chance to return to the regular rhythms of life. And some of them we might not be too excited about. We have to go back to work, or we have to go back to whatever it is we do with our days. And honestly, it's kind of this winter hunker down. The days are short, the nights are long. It's an opportunity maybe to cherish our fireplaces and candles and light and warm ourselves, and that's all good and well. But I want to introduce you to another voice that's come from the wilderness to say to us, hold on there, not so fast. Her name is Fleming Rutledge. She's an Episcopal priest and was one of the women priests ordained not long after the Episcopal Church decided that women were worthy. She also is a prolific author, and currently her latest book is entitled Epiphany. She suggests, and this is the premise of this book, that Epiphany is the least appreciated and understood season. And honestly, that kind of called me to task. This is what she writes about it. All the seasons of the church calendar are formed around Jesus, but there is a sense in which Epiphany is the most specifically Christological season. So let me say that another way. What she's suggesting is that we not waste the season of Epiphany, because in our scriptures for Epiphany, the glory of God is manifest in Jesus Christ. And that's what Epiphany is all about, my friends. We have Advent when we come in, which is awaiting light in the darkness. And then we get to Christmas, which is the light overcoming the darkness. And Epiphany is following the light to its glorious source. It is a season of glory. A season of glory manifests for us in Jesus Christ. Now, in this season, we don't want to miss it. We don't want to miss that Jesus is being revealed as our Messiah, our Savior, the Son of God. And to glorify Jesus also glorifies why he's here. Yesterday was the feast of the Epiphany, and it generally is not celebrated so much anymore. But it's an important story, an important narrative. It kind of is this lovely bridge between our Christmas into Epiphany, and it's because of the Magi, of those astrologers, of those star seekers that discovered a star that they just could not take their eyes off. They were drawn to find out what this star was about. And they make a crazy journey, not to find a baby in a manger, but for a king, royalty. And that's why they bring those crazy gifts. We set them up with our nativity scene, and some of us put them in the back. I can remember doing that as a kid at our house. The wise men and their camels had to go at the back of the living room and make their way slowly to the nativity. It was a long journey. And when they found Mary and Jesus, there was great joy because they knew they had found royalty, the king of the Jews, the king of all. And in our gospel lesson this morning from Mark, we jump right to that, don't we? We jump right to the prophet Isaiah's prophecy being fulfilled, that one will come and make the path. And this, for us, is where following the light begins. It begins in our journey of baptism into the water, the releasing of our sins, not just once, but forever. And in that release, we too share in this light of Christ. This light that's given to the world. And what starts as a flicker dreamed about in Advent is now realized and growing into a widening circle of light that we carry with Christ into the world. I wish Peanuts would do a series about this. Right? It'd be fun to hear Linus read this gospel. But we don't. Which means it's up to us. So I have a little challenge for you. If you're so inclined and have the way of doing it, get a church calendar. Print out that liturgical calendar and keep it close. The calendar of days. And know that that is you. That is your Christian life. That is the spiritual flow that God is calling you to. In a minute, we are going to renew our baptismal covenant. We are going to have the opportunity to remember that feeling of water. Let the heavens be torn open for us and be alongside Christ as a beloved, as a child of God. Let us pray. Oh God, by the leading of a star, you manifested your only Son to the peoples of the earth. Lead us, who know you now by faith, to your presence, where we may see your glory face to face. Amen.
Please stand. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of the bread, and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you preserve in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
In peace, we pray to you, Lord God.
For all people in their daily life and work.
For our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone.
For this community, the nation, and the world.
For all who work for justice, freedom, and peace.
The just and proper use of your creation.
For the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression.
For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble.
For those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy.
For the peace and unity of the Church of God.
For all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth.
For Michael, our presiding bishop, Andy, Kay, Jeff, and Hector, our bishops, and for all bishops and other ministers.
For all who serve God in the church.
For the special needs and concerns of this congregation, especially Tia, Mike, Sally, Elizabeth, Jim, Bud, Nancy, Ben, Joyce, Jeanette, Robin, Marcia, Gennaro, Dee, Mary Ann, Bishop Curry, Beth, Emily, Catherine, Kenyon, Kale, Daniel, and the Grace family. And whoever else we are praying for. Hear us, Lord.
For your mercy is great.
We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life. We will exalt you, O God, our King.
And praise your name forever and ever.
We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. Especially Anne, Joy, Linda, Todd, and Cynthia. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them
who put their trust in you.
Let's pray.
Grant us, O God, that your holy and life-giving Spirit may so move every human heart that barriers which divide us may crumble, suspicions disappear, and hatred cease, that our divisions being healed, all people may live in justice and peace. Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us greet one another. Peace be with you.
turn to page 9 at the back of your bulletin, please. First, I'd like to thank Lecia for being with us today. She'll be with us next week also. We'll see what surprises she has for us now. I just want to say, David and I were talking about this. I think I've said it to a few of you already. It has, to me, really been a treat hearing sermons from so many voices in the time we have had supply priests. We haven't had a bad one yet, I think that's really been, that's been fun about this whole thing during a, what could have been a really challenging time. So I have much appreciation for the people who have come in and supplied for us during this time. The winter shelter, you can read it. I don't have to go over all of it. I've already made a delivery of some of the tarps. Kathy's back in working order again. Tarps, sleeping mats, hats and gloves, all of this is in preparation for the winter shelter. And one more thing, and that is, if you would like to be helpful on a night when we have a shelter, or even a day, then you need to let Kathy Klein know, and she'll put you on the list that will receive the information, and it's a sign-up genius, and it will have places that you can sign up, like for tacos in the morning, or to help with food prep, or to actually be there for the overnight. It is held over at the Methodist Church, United Methodist, next to the HED. We used to not be able to say that, right? Anyway, men's breakfast. There is a small group of gentlemen, I think they are, anyway, who gather together on Sunday morning once a month, and everybody is invited to attend this. If you want a Jim's breakfast, then it is the place to be. And you get together at what time, Larry?
We get together at 8.
Okay.
And there's a little mistake in the book, and probably in the Bible.
What would you like to correct?
It's the 14th, not the 10th.
Okay, so it is on the 14th. All right, so what, I mean, if they show up and nobody's there, they can still eat breakfast, right? Okay. All right, MLK Day is coming up on the 15th, and many Episcopal churches in Austin are participating in this. I didn't put everything here. Madeline used to do this. They start at the MLK statue on UT Mall, and then they walk to the Capitol. Then there's some speakers at the Capitol, and then they walk all the way over to Tilston, Houston. So I'm just making it easy for us and saying, if anyone would like to go to the rally at the Capitol on that day, let me know, and we can gather together and do carpooling if you need to. And then we'll park, and there still would be some walking because you're going to need to get from the parking lot to the Capitol steps. But let me know, and I'll be going, and probably some others. The EYC Pet Supply Drive, there, you make dogs bark everywhere in enjoyment. All right, Lissa said it went wonderfully, and she thanks you so very much for that. At this time, those who would like to have a blessing for a birthday in January or an anniversary, would you please come forward? Come on up, Tom.
Birthday. So we have Tom and Chuck and Marnie and Marnie. Turn so everybody can see your beautiful faces.
There we go. So if you'd like to join me, there's got to be a Book of Common Prayer around here somewhere for y'all. I'm going to be praying prayer number 50 on page 830. Let us pray. O God, our times are in your hand. Look with favor, we pray, on your servants as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace and strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
And everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, because you gave Jesus Christ, your only Son, to be born for us, who by the mighty power of the Holy Spirit was made perfect man of the flesh of the Virgin Mary, his mother, so that we might be delivered from the bondage of sin and receive power to become your children. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself, in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit, to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. At the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him, and with him, and in him. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah.
Christ.
is found on page 14 of your service bulletin. You may stand or kneel. Let us pray.
Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Thank you.